Hello there, my friends. Hope you all are having an awesome day right now. So in the last video, we looked at how the heap sort algorithm works. And in this video, we are going to write a really cute program to implement the heap sort in Python. So let's get started. So first, let me write the heapify function. So def heapify, and we are going to pass three parameters into the function, which are the list, the length of the list, and the index of the parent node. So in heapify, first we are going to assign largest with I, and that's because largest is the index of the current largest element, and the left child will have the index L, and that is going to be I into 2 plus 1, and the right index is going to be greater than the left child's index by 1, so I into 2 plus 1. So this is not I into 2, it's just I into 2. So if first, let us compare the left child with the parent. So L less than N and array of L greater than array of largest. So if this is true, then we are going to assign largest with the value of L. And the same goes for right. I'll just copy this and paste it over here. So if right is less than n and array of right is greater than array of largest, then largest will be r. So now we have got the largest among the three. So all that is left is the swapping part. So we are going to swap only if largest and I are not the same element. So if largest not equal to I, and today I'm going to teach you a shortcut to swap two elements. So array of largest and comma array of I is equal to array of I comma array of largest. So array of largest is going to store the value of this one right here, array of I, and array of I is going to store the value of array of largest. So easy swapping. And after swapping, we are going to also call heapify again. So heapify, the array will be the same one array, the length of the array will be n. And this time, instead of I, we are going to pass the largest, since we are going to heapify that child node which got swapped. So that is our heapify function. And now let us proceed to write our heap sort function. So let me call it heap underscore sort, the same name that we used in the working video. And it will take two arguments, array and the length of the array. So first, we are going to use the for loop to iterate through the heap and build a max heap. So for I in range n by 2 minus 1 comma minus 1, and the step value is going to be minus 1 because we are going from the last to the first. So we are going to decrement by 1. So that is why this third argument has come here. So we are going to heapify the array. The length of the array is n, and I is the index of the parent node. So initially, the last parent node will have this index, and the first parent node will have 0, which is coming just after minus 1. So that's it. We have built a max heap. And after building a max heap, we are going to again include a for loop to call the, to swap the first and the last elements. So in this case, we are going to iterate from n minus 1 to 0. And minus 1 is again going to be our step because we are going from the end to the start. So in this case, we are going to swap the elements at the ith position and the zeroth position. So equal to array of 0 comma array of I. So we have swapped them, and after swapping, we have to again call the heapify for the rest of the elements, excluding the ith element, which has just now been put into its correct position. So array, the length will be I, and the index of parent will be 0. So now that has completed our heap sort function, and all that we need to do now is give a test array and call the heap sort function. So let me give this array 10, 7, 8, 11, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is my list, and heap sort this list. So A, and the length of this is 8. So 8, and we are going to print the sorted list in the end. So that's it. Let's pray that our program works. I'm going to test it right now, and we have got an error. So float object cannot be interpreted as an integer. So where have we got the float object? So yeah, here in this place, we are going to do integer division and not the normal kind of division where we get decimal places, because the indices of arrays or lists cannot be floating point numbers. So that was the issue. And now if we run, the program should work. So we have got it. So we have got this array, but it is not sorted. All the other elements are sorted, but 8 is not in its correct position. So we have gone wrong somewhere. So let me check that. So, okay, yeah. So here it should not be 1, it should be 2, because R, the index of the right child will always be 1 greater than the index of the left one. So this should be 2, and now the program should work. 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 8, 10, 11. So the program has worked. It has sorted the elements in the correct order. And yep, so that completes this video, guys. We have looked at how the heap sort algorithm works, and we have also implemented this algorithm in Python. As usual, the code will be available in my GitHub, and the links will be in the description. And recently I also created social media accounts for this channel, so you can also find the links to them in the description. Make sure that you follow me over there as well. Thanks for watching. Please share this video with anyone who will be in need of it. And bye for now. See you in the next video, where we'll be looking at the next sorting algorithm.